Good afternoon, guys. Kenny here, Brave the Wilds. So, a couple months ago, I made a candle, at least the first stage of it, and this is a poured candle. I've showed you guys how to pour candles before, but not quite like this. And I also plan on showing you some hand-dipped candles later in the future, but that's not going to be today. I've got too many things I got to do today. But, you know, a problem that I saw when I was pouring candles is wax cools from the outside in. So what happens is it creates a shell on the outside of the wax, and then the inside is still condensing when it cools, and it creates a cavity on the inside. So, and I've done it before like 5 times. Every time you go to burn it, the wick ends up dropping through once it burns through that first outer shell, and it goes into the cavity, and you lose your candle, and you have to start all over. So I read online the solution to it, and basically what you need to do is, and I've sort of done it here, is I've got a skewer that I use to do this, but you pour the candle in here, and that's a very basic step. I've shown you guys how to do that before, so I'm not going to cover that today. But what you do is you pour the candle, and then as it cools, you take that skewer, and you poke holes through the top. And you bring them all the way down to the bottom of the candle. And if you guys can see, I'll zoom in on the camera for you. So there's holes in there, and so that way, what we do is, I'm melting up some wax right now. We're going to go ahead and pour in here and finish it off, because when I poured it up to the threads here, and as you can see, it's sunk down quite a bit, and it has a lot of cavities in there. So once we pour it, put your wick in there when it's still liquid enough that you can slide it in there, and then take your wax after it cools, heat up another batch of wax, and pour it in there, and that will eliminate the cavities when we go to light it. So give me a minute for this wax to cool, and we'll finish this candle. Okay guys, well, we got our wax. We got enough melted for what we need. So as you can see, we have a pretty good sized cavity right there. And then all the rest needs to be filled in. I like to get it up to the threads. And if we have to pour this a second time after we do this pour, that's okay if we want to get it up to the height in there that we want. So I'm fairly confident this is going to spill. So I went ahead and put a few boards down. And we're just going to go ahead and... So what's going to happen is since that wax is really hot, it's going to kind of melt down the candle a little bit of the wax, but that's okay. That's just what happens when you pour really hot wax into just room temperature wax. It's going to start to heat up the other wax, but I kind of need that because the skewer is kind of lodged in there. But as you can see, let me get this camera. We've filled in that big hole right there with wax. It's poured all the way down there. And that will eliminate that cavity effect when we go to burn this thing. Okay guys, so we just poured it in here, and it's not quite dry yet, but that really doesn't matter too much. It'll still let us burn it if we want to. It doesn't have to be totally done. I mainly just want to test burn and see how it does compared to what it's been doing. So let me go ahead and light this thing up. Bit windy. Is it going? Yep, it's barely going. Now I'll get kicked up here in a minute. So we're going to let that sit and let it burn for a few minutes and see how it's going to work. And this is going to be a great addition to the hut this winter time. So we can have some good lighting, and then when we're done using it, we can just screw it on and carry it around to wherever we need it. And then when we want to use it again, we can just take off the lid and light it up. So we're going to let that sit and burn for a few minutes, and then we'll bring you back. Okay, guys, well, this candle's been burning for probably about 10 minutes now. I have my stopwatch on, and it burned for about 10 minutes. And as you can see, you know, it looks like there's no wax even have come off of it yet. And, you know, I have no idea how long this candle is going to burn, but I can tell you it's going to burn for a very, very, very long time. Because since it's in a container, all the wax just keeps melting in and soaking that wick and just keeping it burning nice and good. I mean, that's a tall flame. And that right there is going to give off a lot of light in the hut. Granted, we've got a little bit of smoke, but I think that's because we've got a lot of wind. So once this thing gets down a little bit lower and stuff like that, it's going to burn a lot more consistently. and it's going to burn for a long time. And like I said, once you're done using it, you can just blow it out, cap it off, and you're good to go. So thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed that. Hope that helped you out for these guys struggling on those hand-dipped candles. Or I'm sorry, not those hand-dipped candles, but those poured candles, having some struggles with the wick falling through. I hope that helped you guys out and kept you from having to make the same mistake I did. Have a good day. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.